So that's a little background out of the way. Now you can probably see where I'm heading with all of this. Someone who can't see the screen can't access the visual information in the interface. And someone who's using voice control relies on the voice control software being able to interact with a web page. So we need to make sure that information is expressed in a way which is flexible enough to be accessed programmatically by assistive technology, which can then create an alternative user interface to suit its users' needs. We refer to this as expressing the semantics of an element. The WebAIM checklist explicitly calls this out in Guideline 4.1, saying, name role value markup is used in a way that facilitates accessibility. Okay, that's kind of terse. The Web Content Accessibility Guidelines go into a bit more detail. For all user interface components, the name and role can be programmatically determined. States, properties, and values that can be set by the user can be programmatically set. So what are name, role, and value, and how can we make sure that they can be programmatically determined and set? To answer that, we're going to start off by trying things out from the point of view of someone using assistive technology. Just before we jump into that, I want to quickly mention that in this course, we will be working mostly with screen readers. But a lot of the work we do to support screen readers also benefits users who use other assistive technologies. Things like voice control and switch control use the same programmatically expressed semantics. In the introduction, we had a first look at using a screen reader. Now we're going to try using one without any access to the web page's visible interface.